Hello everyone, this is Kenny Bruni from Cambridge Tech and welcome back to the channel. So in this series of videos, you are learning Bootstrap 5, and in this particular video, we are going to learn about the grid system or the grid layout. So let's go back into the Bootstrap official website, and that's getbootstrap.com. I'll click on all releases. Remember, we are learning version 5.1 and we are going to look at some documentation material over here. So when I click on layout, you can see we have the grid over here. So there's some bit of information over here, which reads, use our powerful mobile first Flexbox grid to build layouts of all shapes and sizes, thanks to a 12 column system. So pay attention to this. There's a 12 column system, and I'm going to explain with examples. 6 default responsive tiers, SAS variables and mixins, and dozens of predefined classes. All right. So there's an example over here. And as you can see, we have some columns showing up over here. But in order to understand this concept very well, I have this over here. So this is more or less a grid layout. Look at this like maybe a website, and the horizontal cross sections, as you can see over here, are the rows. So in this particular example, let's say we have row 1, row 2, row 3, and row 4, and the vertical cross sections are the columns. So we have column 1, column 2, column 3, and column 4. So let's pay particular attention to row 1. Row 1, for instance, okay, we have one row over here divided into four columns. All right, we have one row divided into four columns. So let's say we can have a website where this three columns will have like the main area where we can write an article, and this fourth column will be the aside section. And that is exactly what Bootstrap gives us right out of the box. So in order to get this, we first of all need to have a class of container, then we'll have a row. Then inside of the row, we'll have a number of columns. So as you can see, the row then becomes the parent class of the columns, because all the columns are going to be inside of the row, just as we have over here. This is row 1. And this column are all inside of row 1. All right, so now let's look at a proper example. So just about now, I'm going to come in here and have a container class. So inside of the container, we can have our row, and inside of our row we can have our call. So as you can see, we have a call like this, and let's say we have a text call-1. So when I save this, we now have call-1 over here. Now let me add in some few things over here that will kind of style things up. So inside of our call, let me add in a number of Bootstrap classes. So let me say I'll have a background of dark, then I'll have a padding of 5, let's have a txt-white, and finally let's have a txt-center so that we center the text. So when I save this, now this is what we have for the call-1. Now, like I said, the role is going to be the parent class. Okay, so within this row we can have another column. Okay, so in order to do so, let me just duplicate this. So I'll come in here and I'll do a shift control and a down arrow key to save this. So after saving this, let me change the text over here to call-2. So as you can see, this is call-1 and this is call-2. They are joined together. We are later on going to look at how we can separate them and see other things. But let me change this background to primary so that we see the clear distinction between the two. So this is call-1 and this is call-2. Good. Now let me open things up a little bit, and let me try and shrink this. Now remember the responsiveness we spoke about with the containers. Now when I shrink this, you don't seem to have any problem over here. Okay, now this is just the default way of doing things. Let me open this up once again. Now we can actually specify with some kind of demarcation how large we want it to be. Now by default, as stated over here, we have a 12 column grid system. Okay, we have a 12 column, so within a row we can have 12 columns. That's basically what this means. So what then that means is, if I do call and leave it blank, it is automatically going to adjust and do an equitable distribution of the number of columns I have within the row. So clearly this is going to take about 6, and this is going to also going to take about 6, the background dark and the background primary. So when I do, let's say, a call 8, remember we have 12, so call 8, that means the DAC is going to be called 8. So when I save this, you can see that there's a shift over here. When I open this up, you can see that this is taking 8 columns and this is taking the rest of the 4. So I can leave it like this, but under normal circumstance, after doing call dash 8, you also need to come and specify call dash 4 over here. It wouldn't make any difference over here. But if I'm to make call dash 2, that means we are going to be left with some extra 2 over here. So as you can see, there's some gap we can add on in order to make it 12. However, if I do a call dash, let's say 6, now 6 plus 8 is giving me 14. Remember, the dark background has a call demarcation of 8 and this has a 6. So when I save this, clearly you can see that it is unable to accommodate the rest of the 6 over here. It's supposed to be 4, but now I'm seeing 6, so it automatically brings it down, and that's very important. So having gone through this, let me just go back to 6 and 6. So 6 and 6 is going to set it to the default. If you don't specify, let's say I don't specify anything over here, it is automatically going to adjust. And let me add in a number of columns. So I'll do a shift alt and a down arrow key, and let me change this particular one to, let's say, danger, and let me change this to info. So I'll save this and let me change the text as well. So I have 3 over here and I have 4 here. All right, so as you can see, this will automatically adjust. And if I open this up, so as you can see over here, this is going to take the same size as the others because we didn't specify, so it is automatically going to adjust. So how many columns do you have over here? We have 1, 2, 3, 4. So basically what this means is, under normal circumstance, the entire thing is going to be 12. So it's going to be 12 divided by 4. That means automatically this has taken 3, this has also taken 3, the call 3 has taken 3, and same as the call 4. So let's look at other examples, and that's going to be very interesting. So let's look at another class, and let me give a margin y over here. A margin y of 5, so that I kind of separate it, give a margin to the top and bottom. So down over here, I'll have a container, and once again I'll have a row, then I'll have a call dash 8. Then inside of the call dash 8, I'm going to have an h4, and I'm going to say title. So I have title showing up over here. And let's say I have a paragraph, and I can have a lorem ipsum 100. So this is the text I want to show up over here. And the next thing I would want to do over here is, first of all, we need to make sure that we are going to have the other column within the row, because the row is going to be the parent class. So we need to come down here and do a call dash 4. Remember, the first one was 8. Then let me have an h4 once again, and I'll do a side section. Then I'll have in a paragraph over here, and let's say I have in lorem ipsum some dummy text showing up over here. So this is going to be the main section, and this is going to be the aside section. Now when I open this up, you can see that it looks pretty awesome. Okay, we didn't have to do much, we just had to use the grid system. So let me try and shrink this up a little bit. Now when I continue to shrink this up, and the reason why we are shrinking this up is to look out for how our website is going to look on different screen sizes. So when we look at this, we don't seem to have anything so much of a difference except for this particular one. So as you can see, call 4 is now shifting to the button, okay, or it's going beneath call 1, 2, and 3, and that's one of the reasons why we need the grid system, because it makes our work very simple, very responsive to different screen sizes, so on and so forth. So in the next video, we are going to look at the breakpoint, okay, and that's going to make a lot of sense. But finally, let me show one last thing over here. So let me come down here and come and have a container, and of course this can be in a container fluid or a container. So let's say we have a container fluid over here. So let me show you a simple shortcut you can use. Now I can do row, so that's going to give me the row class. Okay, when I do a dot, and let's say do my-5, that means I need a div of all these classes. So I need a row and also my-5. So when I press enter, now you can see that we have a div of these classes showing up over here. All right, so over here, let me say I want a row. I want a call, because we are within the row, and within the call, let's say we want a background dash dark. Then I'll do another dot because I need another class. I want a txt dash white. Then I'll do a dot txt dash center. Then I'll do a paragraph. A padding dash 5. Then I'll do a dot border. Then I'll do another dot border dash white. Then I'll do another dot border dash 5. All right, so this is going to be a bunch of Bootstrap classes over here, but essentially this is what it means. Okay, we have all these showing up over here, and let's just have, let's say, call one for the text. So that's essentially what we have over here. Now I'm using the prettier extension, so anytime I save, it automatically formats my code for me. Okay, so don't worry so much about what you see over here. It's basically everything you are going to see if you do exactly what I'm doing. So let's say this is a call. Okay, this is a call div. So let's copy this over here. So I'll do a Control C and I'll paste it over here. So when I save, I can see that we have some gap over here. This is not actually a gap. Okay, this is where we are getting it from. So I'm just giving a border on the calls. I'm just giving a border of border white, and I'm just making this a little bit thick. Okay, if I do it one and save, you can see that we are going to have some differences over here. So I'll just go back to 5. All right, so let me change the text over here to 42, and I'm going to have a number of these showing up over here. So just hold on. So after saving this, this is exactly what we have. Okay, so you have call 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now this is exactly what I want to show, and if I'm to shrink this a little bit, you can see that at different screen sizes there's some kind of modification or adjustment to our layout. Now when I shrink it further, you can see that now call 7 and call 8 will come beneath call 1 to 6. Now when I further shrink this, you can see that we are having a different layout, and obviously this is also going to be a different layout. And finally, I think this is just about the last layout we can have as far as this goes. And like I keep on saying, when we look extensively at the breakpoint, which is going to be in the next video, we are going to appreciate a lot of these things very well. Now finally, I would want to show something over here. So let me have these two showing up. And once again, let me just have a container. So I'll do a container, and I'll do a dot row dot my5. That means I want these two classes over here. So I'll do a call dash 4, and I want a background. So I'll do a bg dash dark over here. Then I'll do dot a padding of 5, and I'll do a txt dash center dot a txt dash white. And inside of this, let's have a call 1 over here. All right, so because we are in a container class, that's why we have this margin showing up over here. So now let's duplicate this. So I'll just, anywhere on this line, I'll do a shift down arrow key to duplicate this, and this is what we have showing up. Very interesting. Now let's have, and that's why I had to bring in the border classes over here, so that we can see some kind of a difference. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click over here, and I'm just going to have a border dash white. Then I'll do a border dash 5. So when I save this, you can see that, let me refresh, you can see that we have this border showing up over here. Now let me just copy these border classes. So I'll do a control C. Later on, we are going to look at borders extensively and bring it in here so that this is also going to look exactly the same. All right. So let me just change this text to, let's say, 42. Sorry. So this is what we have over here with the two columns. Okay. So there seem to be a space over here. When I open or when I stretch this up, we seem to have some kind of space over here. Now, there are a number of Bootstrap classes, especially within the version 5, that we can use over here. And these are basically the Flexbox properties in CSS. So on top of the row, let me come over here. So this is call 1 and call 2. So on top of this row, we can add in some Flexbox properties. So I can do justify dash content dash. Now I can do end. When I do end and save, you can see that we have this floating to the end. Okay. And let me open this up. As you can see, it is now floating to the end. And this is just the Flexbox properties. Now I can do, obviously, when I do start, start is going to be from the start. Okay. Now I can do center. Okay, so justify content center. And when I do justify content center, you can see that this is now put to the center. Okay, so it takes care of the other size of it. Now I can also do between. So justify content between, or justify dash content dash between. And this is going to be on the row. That's the parent class. So when I save this, now this is going to, let me open this up. Now this is going to maximize the margins or the distance between the two of them. Okay. And this is basically the Flexbox properties we have in CSS. So this is one of the new add-ons in the version 5. So this is going to be the end of this video. And the next video, you are going to look at the breakpoints, and a lot of things are going to make sense. Now, if you find this tutorial very interesting, there are a couple of ways you can help me grow my channel. Kindly subscribe to Cambrutech and don't forget to hit on the notification button so that anytime I release a video, you'll be duly notified. Also, share this video with friends and family who will find this content very useful. At Cambrutech, we say learn programming. You can do it. Bye-bye and catch you in the next video.